Hello everyone, I hope all of you are very much safe in your home. Now, today I will continue with the class 10 heredity and common genetic diseases. And our topic for today is the cross, genetic cross for color blindness. Now, let's get started. Now, I have taken colorblind father and carrier mother. So, colorblind father means the X chromosome will be affected. So normal composition of the father will be XY, but as he is colorblind, so it will be XCY because he is colorblind. And carrier mother means XX is the normal composition, but as she is carrier, so 1X will be affected. Got it? So these are the P generation. Gametes will be formed next. Over here what we are getting XC and Y, and over here XC and X. Got it? Now these are the gametes. Now the offspring. This is mother. This is father. So mother is having X, C, X, father is having X, C, Y. It will be multiplied, X, C will be multiplied with both of them. That is, we are having X, C, C. Over here, X, C and X. This one, X, C, Y and X, Y. Got it? So, what are the probabilities that we are getting? That is that 25% colorblind daughter. 25% colorblind daughter, got it? 25% carrier daughter. Got it? 25% carrier daughter. This one, 25% colorblind son. And 25% normal son. So, this is the general probability that if a colorblind man is marrying a carrier woman, so the probabilities of their offsprings will be, they will be having 25% is a chance of having a colorblind daughter, 25% carrier daughter, 25% colorblind son and 25% normal son. So this is the general probability. Okay, now next cross we will move on. Now our next topic for the cross is colorblind father and normal mother. Okay, colorblind father means obviously X is totally affected, X, C, Y. Normal mother means X, X. So this is the P generation. Gametes are formed, X, C, Y. Checkerboard. Sorry, mother genotype we will write X and X, and father will be X, C, Y. So what we are getting X, C, X. So we multiplied with this one, X, C, X, and this one will be like this. And Y will be multiplied with each of them, that is X, Y and X, Y. Got it? So what is the probability? Probability is that 50% of having carrier daughter, 50% of having a normal son. So this is the probability that if a colorblind man marrying a normal woman, so the offsprings they will get of them there is a high chances of getting 50% of career daughter and 50% normal son. If it is a daughter, that means the daughter will be career, but if it is a son, that means the son will be normal. So this is the thing. So next we will move on to the genetic counseling. So let's get started. Okay, so my next topic is genetic counseling. Now what is this genetic counseling? Genetic counseling means we are counseling, or we are actually studying the genetic of a person or genes of a person. Understood? Now before marriage, the genetic counseling is very much required to know whether the man or the woman is having any kind of genetic diseases or not. And before marriage, it should be done. It should be done very importantly. Okay. Otherwise, it will be very much problematic for further situation. Okay. Suppose if a man is having a hemophilia. Okay. But he doesn't know that he is having hemophilia, and then he got married to a girl, and then their offspring, there is a chance that they will have the offspring either hemophilic or carrier. Okay, so there is a very less chance that they can get normal child. Understood? So before marriage, the both the sides of the man and the woman should go for the genetic counseling. Now if we will go for the genetic counseling process, that means we can also reduce the number of the affected persons from hemophilia or colorblind. Understood? So how this genetic counseling is done, and I will show you. But why is this important? Because we want a disease free generation. Okay, and in order to get disease free, we must know that the previous generation is having any kind of diseases or not. If they are having any kind of such diseases, then they should be totally restricted to have any kind of child, because the next generation that they will produce will be having the same genetic disease that they were having. So in order to stop that, and in order to maintain the genetic free generations, we need to perform the genetic counseling. Now how can we perform that, I will show you too. We are starting the genetic counseling cross. Now we'll do it for thalassemia. Okay, plus T and plus T. Understood? Now we know the about carrier. Carrier means they are carrying the gene, the defective gene, but they are not having as such problem. They are not facing as such problem like the affected person. But carrier means they are carrying the gene. Okay. Now, suppose this is the father. Okay. And this is mother. Now what this plus stands for and what this T stands for, that we will write. Plus is equals to normal gene, and T stands for thalassemic gene. Understood? So plus stands for normal gene and T stands for thalassemic gene. Now father is having one normal gene and one thalassemic gene, so as the mother, one normal gene and one thalassemic gene. That means both of them are carrier. Understood? Because they are containing or they are carrying the thalassemic gene. Now they will produce the gametes, plus T plus T. Got it? Now these are the gametes. This is P generation. Now obviously the gametes of both the parents will actually intercross with each other. So this plus at first combining with this plus, so plus plus. Now this plus will combine with this T gene, that means plus T. Now this T gene will again combine with this plus gene, getting my point? So plus T. Now this T gene will now combine with this T. So TT. Got it? So four probabilities we are getting. Not that we are getting four offsprings. Always remember, these are the probabilities. Four probabilities we are getting. First of all, plus plus. Plus stands for normal gene. That means this is a normal person. Or the individual who is having this gene, they will be normal. So this is normal. Plus T means plus and T. That means it is the carrier. So plus T, this one and this one. Both of them are carrier. Got it? Both of them. Plus T. Carrier. TT means T stands for thalassemic gene. So this is thalassemia or thalassemic patient. Got it? So there is one chance of having a normal child, two chances of having a carrier child, and one chances of having thalassemic child. So the chance is 1:2:1. Understood? I mean 25% of chances is there of having a normal child, 50% chance to have a carrier child, and 25% chance to have the thalassemic child. So this is the genetic counseling, and it should be done before marriage in order to stop the disease to spread from generation after generation. So till this much, this entire chapter ends. If you are having any questions, any doubts regarding any cross or any part of the chapter, please feel free to ask me. Okay? And please follow the question answers that I am given to you. Okay? Thank you.